Galatians chapter 1, verse 10. For do I not persuade men, or Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai? Or do I seek to please men? For if I yet please men, I should not be the servant of Yahweh Shai. I want to give our praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, Bashim Rakah Kodash, forgive me the spirit, to this lesson. This lesson is going into only caring about what Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai thinks, and not anybody else, okay? We are here to please them, to do the will, to glorify them on the earth, all right? When you get caught up in what everybody else thinks, even man in the truth, man, okay? If it's not according to the spirit, that is, if you get caught up in that shit, man, then you're going to make the wrong decisions. You're not going to be clear-minded like you're supposed to be. Because at the end of the day, who makes you clear-minded? Who takes away fog from your brain, from your spirit? Only Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, man. A man can't do that. He can teach you. He can give you good advice. But the outcome of that is in the hands of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. Okay? If you become unfoggy or not. Alright? So let's read this again. For do I now persuade men or Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai? Right, man. Always think about them in heaven. Always. Okay? That's what it means, man. Your treasures in heaven, your conversations in heaven, your mind, your spirits in heaven, meaning the order of them, what they want to be done to glorify them on earth. Okay, what they think about it, what they don't like about it. All right? You can't think about people around you like that. Okay, because they're not Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. All right? Even brothers in the truth, man, because you might have a situation where a brother in the truth is not thinking right. But because you want to please him, okay, you do things a certain way that's not pleasing to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. That's going off. Okay, that's why the Lord talks about being a respecter of persons. No, man, it's about his way, and that's it, man. Point blank, period. So let's read that again. For do I now persuade man of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, or do I seek to please man? For if I yet please men, I shall not be the servant of Yahweh Shai, man. Okay? So it's all about the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. Don't get caught up in that madness. Okay? From there, let's go to 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 4. But as we were allowed of Yahweh to be put in trust with the gospel, even so we speak, not as pleasing men, but Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, which trieth our hearts. Right, man. So they know the deep things, man. They know all things, man. They know what's true. They know what's false. They know what's right, and they know what's wrong. Okay? So you can't lose by dealing with them, okay, in your heart, in your soul, what they think about it first. Not what a brother thinks about it first, but what they think about it first. Okay? It goes from them downwards. All right? That's how you got to look at it, man, in the spirit. You got to understand that. You can't care about who don't like you because you did the right thing. Okay? I'm talking about even brothers in the truth, man, that may be going off and not being in the right spirit at that moment or that time. Okay? Because it happens, man. You be around long enough, you'll see it. It happens. Okay? And you can see man pleasers and just saying stuff to comfort, you know, in a wicked way, meaning not considering what Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai thinks at that moment about that particular thing. Okay? You can't let that escape your minds. Alright? From there, let's go to Proverbs chapter 29, starting verse 25. The fear of man bringeth a snare, but whoso put his trust in the Lord shall be safe. Let's concentrate on the first part of that verse. The fear of man bringeth a snare. Right, man? That's talking about in general, man. Okay, not just fearing what man can do unto you, because we know that the scriptures talk about you're supposed to have fear in the Lord, not what man can do, because Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai controls the outcome of everything. Okay, what that man is allowed to do to you. That's why Yahweh Shai told, I forgot the name, but he told someone, hey man, you know, it was given to you from heaven to do this to me. Okay, not of yourself. So we understand that. But even in his truth, man, you can be so fearful, okay, that you don't even put trust in the Lord in that situation because you're fearing what he might think, a brother might think this way or that way. Even though you know your thinking is correct and right according to the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahushua. That's what it's all about, man. Okay? It's not about feelings and emotions and sparing feelings on this and that. It's about the truth, and that's it. It's about glorifying Yahweh Shem Yahushua, and that's it. Not being respectful of persons, not being a man pleaser. Okay? You got to be blunt, man. You got to be honest in this truth, man. Okay? You got to grow that, to be honest. Because, you know, when you first get the truth, man, you want to be liked, okay? You want to fit in, and you really don't understand what this truth is about until years later. And you're still learning, man. I'm still learning, okay? Been in this truth 10 or so years, and I'm still learning, man. Doesn't change, okay? But I have enough experience to understand how this works, okay? Understand that you can make the wrong decision based off not thinking about what Yahweh Shem Yahushua thinks and only thinking about what that brother is thinking for that moment, even though it's a wrong situation, okay? We got to be man in this truth, okay? This truth teaches you how to be a man. Can't escape that. Those are facts, okay? From there, let's go to Romans chapter 12, starting at verse 2. And be not conformed to this world, but be you transformed by the renewing of your mind. The renewing of your mind. Okay? Those ways are of the world, man. Okay? Because this world doesn't have the truth. So when you come into the truth, you got to take that ways that you learned from the world, man, and leave it there, man. Okay? This is about Yahweh by Hashem, Yahusha, man. The will of Yahweh. That's what this is about, man. Stick to that, you can't lose. Stick to fearing them, you can't lose, man. Okay? You can't lose, man. It doesn't matter what a brother thinks, man. If it's the truth, if it's spiritual and right on time, meet for due season, it don't matter what a brother thinks about that, man. Guess what? Yahweh Shem Yahushua controls the outcome of how he thinks. So, you always got to start from the top, all right? So it says, but be you transformed by the renewing of your minds, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of Yahweh. Right, man. The will of Yahweh. That is what this is about, man. Doing his will. Okay? And you can't be scared, man. You got to be honest, man. There's nothing wrong with being an honest brother, man. Okay? As long as you are respectful, okay? You have your Yahweh Shem Yahushua in mind and the spirit, then be real, man. Don't be faking this truth, okay? Certain things you see, you're going to have to say something, man. Just what it is, man, okay? You do it within order, okay, and meet for due season, man, all right? But you can't think about what brothers think about all the time, about you, if you did this, man. Just make your move in the spirit, man. Okay? Make your move in the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahushua and do what you are supposed to do for them. And everything else will take care of itself. All right? For example, say you made a move that you were scared to make because, oh, you felt like this brother's going to think this way and da-da-da. I didn't want him to think that way. Say you did it and it was right in Yahweh Shem Yahushua's eyes, but not in his eyes. Well, that's on him, man. You did what you're supposed to do, man. You don't worry about that. You put that in Yahweh Shem Yahushua's hands, okay? Not in your own mind that makes you alter a good decision and make it a bad decision. All right? Verse 3. For I say, through grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly according as Yahweh hath dealt to every man the measure of faith. And a lot of times, when younger brothers especially, they see a brother, you know, thinking highly of himself or coming in that spirit, man, they get scared to talk. They get scared to be honest, to be real. And we got to be real, man. You know, as brothers in this truth, we got to be real brothers, man. Can't be fake. Like in the world, man, they carry that spirit. Just say things because they know you want to hear it, man. Forget all that shit. That's worldly bullshit. We can't bring that in the truth. All right? Last scripture, 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 21. Providing for the honest things, not only in the sight of the Lord, but also in the sight of man. Right, man. And at the end of the day, Yahweh Shema Washah respects you to be honest and be real, man. Okay? Not be honest as far as it's ignorant what you're saying, and you just honestly stating what you feel, even though it's stupid. I'm talking about with wisdom. Honesty with wisdom, man. Being real. Okay? Why? Because you only care about what Yahweh Shema Washah thinks. And that's it. Remember, everything else will take care of itself. So I hope you're edified. I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem, Rakah, Kodash. Forgive me the spirit to do this lesson. Double honor to the elders of Great Millstone. And Shalom to you, Akamai, that is doing the truth and sincerity. Shalom.